Hello everyone, today I am recording this video for all those who are going to appear for FRM part 1 in November. Okay, so basically there are different kinds of students who are going to listen to this video, so I bifurcate the viewers. Basically those who haven't started their preparation yet, or they have started but not yet done well with their preparation till that time, or might be you have done your preparation might be through self-studies or through coaching, but you are unable to understand the pattern of examination, how to approach the examination, or might be you are not confident with your preparation. Clear? Or the third category, which is completely differentiated for the working professionals. If you are working, I can understand that it's very difficult to study 2 hours or 3 hours a day. Okay, so what can be done for all those who have started, not yet started, or they have taken coaching but still struggling to get that particular mentorship which is necessary to pass the exam in one shot? Or might be you have given the exam previously but you are unable to clear and you want to re-attempt the examination with more confidence, with better preparation, with better confidence of your own that yes, this time I am going to clear. So this video is completely directed to them. Now, when it comes to me, I am teaching FRM to India as well as to the countries like Australia, Switzerland, France, Italy, Croatia, Saudi Arabia, then Dubai, African countries like Lesotho, South Africa, okay, and Togo. So students are all around the world, from Pakistan, okay, from Afghanistan. Students are from Middle East countries, as I said, Dubai, Saudi Arabia, Jordan, so Australia, Hong Kong. Students are from everywhere where I am mentoring. Now, what is the reason that students from all over the globe coming to us for their FRM preparation? What extra and what else we are giving to the student? So basically, this lecture is about that. Now, when it comes to the first point, which you won't find anywhere, is the test in every 10 days. Means we believe in the fact that we are going to take test on a regular basis. It will help in two or three manner. One, you will not derail from your preparation. The preparation keeps in continuation. Second, wherever you are making the mistakes, that can be identified at the same moment and that can be corrected. Because if you will take test after say 20 days, 30 days or 2 months, what will happen? The mistakes is continue to be there and there is no scope of improving the mistake. Clear? So it's better to take test on a regular basis, and that will be mentored by me, directly under me. There will be a test report generated after the test and that will be completely checked by me, and then based on that test report I'll be giving the suggestions to improve your marks, and which are those areas where you are weak you can identify after giving the test, and then we will work more and more efficiently, because now we are able to understand our mistake and then we can work on the mistakes. So once we are done with our mistake, there is no scope of failing the exam. So again, if I am taking test on a regular interval, this is helping us, okay, helping me to monitor your performance, helping you to keep yourself on the track with your performance, with your syllabus. Because what happened now, when you start studying, you are very motivated. But when you are like 15 days or 30 days with your preparation, you feel boring, okay, and you try to skip the things. So what will happen in that scenario? You need some motivation that can motivate to keep you on track with the preparation, and that test will do that task to keep you on track with your preparation. Because I am very strict when it comes to the test. I take test and I will definitely take test without any delay. Clear? Syllabus will be scheduled according to your time constraint. Might be a student who can study 2 hours a day, a different time schedule for him. Someone who is a college student who is not working, he can study 7 to 8 hours a day. The different schedule will be there. So accordingly, we'll mentor you, we'll guide you. Clear? So this is the first thing which you won't find anywhere. That's the reason students are approaching us. Next, a regular follow-up from my side means when it comes to me, if I am saying that I have one student, Tarun, so I know how much syllabus he has completed. What is left? What are those portions which are left? What are those portions in which he is weak? So accordingly, I keep on guiding him on a regular interval. There is always a regular follow-up from my side. There are students of mine on a daily basis or twice, like in 3 days or once, they message me and they update me, sir, I have completed 10 readings. Sir, I am completing 4 readings. So today I have completed CAPM, but these are the areas where I am facing problem. What should I do? Please guide me. So these are the thing which I personally do to ensure that students are completely under my trace. So again, this you won't find from any teacher. Means I have seen students, they say that teacher don't even remember my name. So how come they will remember your performance? How come they are going to test your performance? The third and the foremost, I personally clear your doubts. There are no intermediaries in between, not at all. Means no WhatsApp group, no forums, nothing. You directly approach me, I will solve your doubt. Because one thing I really understand, when it comes to teaching or when it's come to the profession of lawyer or when it comes to the profession of doctor, if you don't tell your problem to them, they won't be able to help you. Clear? And they are the expertise. These are the field of expertise. If I am the expertise of the teaching, if I have that expertise and you are asking doubt from someone who is subordinate to me, or I have hired someone to help you to solve the doubt, they might not be most efficient. They can solve your doubt. I am supporting that, the fact they will solve your doubt. But they are unable to understand the fact that why you are creating this mistake and what should be done to ensure that you won't do this mistake again. That is important. Means if you are asking a silly doubt in CAPM, what I will say? I will say that your concept of CAPM is not well structured. First work upon the concept of CAPM and then you will see you are not going to ask this doubt. Clear? So the subordinate who is solving the doubt, he can solve your doubt, but he is unable to give you the suggestion that what you are lacking, where your concepts are lacking. Because trust me, if there are 60 readings in FRM part 1, no one is efficient with all the 60. Okay, there are 5 to 10 readings in which some student face difficulty, might be some face difficulty with options, some face difficulties with the portion of fixed income, some face difficulties with war, or some do with the quants. There are the areas. So what are the ways, what are the steps I need to take to ensure that these mistakes must not persist in the future? So that's the three key points on which I always focus on my students. One, the regular test. Second, the follow-up. And the third, direct doubt solved by me. There will be regular practice revision. Now, when it comes to the practice test, I have structured in such a way that suppose in the first 10 days you complete your first 4 readings and I am taking the test of first 4 reading. Now the second test will take place after next 10 days and you will complete next 4 reading. So now what will happen? In the next test, there will be the test of the complete 8 reading. So means you are covering up the recent chapters as well and you are revising the previous one. Now can you see? You are gaining trust, you are revising the previous topics, you are gaining more and more confidence, because in the previous test you might have scored 55%, but in this test you have scored say 58%. See, sir, I have improved by 3%. That's the key, my dear friend. You need to improve. Learn from the mistakes which you did earlier and do not commit the same. But yes, keep on improving. Either by a single 1%, we will improve. Definitely the first test will be like 40% correct. Second test 44% correct, 48 correct, 50, 52, 56. Our target is to reach 75% correct questions must be answered by us. 75% questions must be corrected by us. And trust me, if you will be able to clear those 75 question benchmark, no one can let you fail. It's a promise. I can really promise you that if 1 month well before the exam, you will gain this confidence that yes, I am able to correct 75% questions. No one can fail me, provided my day must be best. So means there is a continuous revision. There is a continuous test. Regular doubt solving will be there from my side. Now for all those who haven't started their preparation yet or started their preparation but not confident with your preparation and not sure what you are going to do, So trust me, my dear friends, it's better to invest some more time, some more money and save your future 6 months. Means if you are able to clear your exam in November, definitely you can appear for FRM part 2 in May. So means in short, you are going to save your 6 months. And one more important thing which is completely priceless, that is your confidence. What happened most of the time, I have seen students, they fail and they don't have that much confidence to reappear their exam again. So means once you fail, you lose your confidence, you lose your trust. Even there is always a question mark from the side of the family that see, you asked us to help you in giving the exam in FRM, we helped you but you are unable to succeed. Hopefully you are understanding the fact. And those who are working professionals, they have their personal family life, they have their children. Also, when it comes to the office, they forget everything. Means, apart from all these things, the family, the office, the personal life, you need to devote time to your studies. So how it will be structured? Just contact me. I am going to help you out, whether you are working professional or college student, whether you have started your preparation or you haven't started your preparation. But yes, do it immediately, because now each and every single day is important to us, each and every single day. And if you had appeared previously, you have completed your syllabus, unable to pass or unable to score good percentage, approach me, we'll see what we can do. Where are your weaknesses? Definitely I contact each and every person individually. I'll be giving my contact number with you so that you can come and contact me. Okay, just leave a message on WhatsApp so that I can communicate you with you. So from our side, you will be getting the lectures, practice test, mock papers, notes, every 10-day test, regular follow-up and mentorship, and wherever you are facing problem, that will be solved on an instantaneous basis. So these are the area where we are going to work for you. Clear? So I am just ending this video. Whatever details you need, you can find it in the description box and my number is there. Just reach out to me. That's it. I can help you in the best possible way. We'll plan your studies, we'll strategize in the best manner for you so that you can pass in the first shot. Okay, the confidence means this is the thing which I want. Sir, if I can get this confidence, trust me, I can pass. Okay, you might have completed the syllabus, but you are nervous. Okay, this is the fact that I want my student to have that confidence. Dekho, we'll see pass or not. Okay, that confidence will make the half war win for you. That confidence itself. Okay, syllabus is the secondary thing. Just talk to me. That's the only possible way I can help you out. Means a one-to-one mentorship will be there for you. Just reach out to me. Okay. Thank you.